Spend most of my days trying to fight the feeling. Then out of nowhere, the thought is so appealing. I used to spend my days trying to run my game on some beautiful face with a nice tight frame.
Nice tight frame.
Didn't matter if it's love, didn't think about the pain. But now I'm grown and I'm sexy, and I'm ready to change. Baby, I'm thinking it's time. For the record, girl, I love you.
I love you.
And in my heart, there's no one else above you.
One above you.
And I'm so thankful that you stuck beside me.
Yes.
'Cause without you, girl, I don't know where I would be.
Oh, no.
Through all my silly talk, arguments I made, all the nights I left you lonely, so I can play.
So I can play.
It didn't matter if it's love.
No.
It's a brand new day, baby. I'm thinking it's time.
Oh, give away the bride.
Mother.
All right. Now we're gathered here as witnesses for the uniting, the official uniting of Adam and Kimila together that God has blessed. And certainly it's a continual blessing that continues to go on forever and ever. Amen?
Amen.
And so we're going to get into exactly what that means in a moment, but right before we're going to open up with prayer.
In the Christian Holy Bible, you will find these words. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Thank you for the union between Adam and Kimberly. We know your special grace and your love are with them. Adam and Kimberly honor you by coming together as one to live out their lives according to your will and your way. Continue to keep them as only you can. When the challenges of life are not so pleasant, they have their faith in you to hold on to. Keep them and they shall be kept. Bless them and they shall be blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And for Jesus' sake, amen.
I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over sideways and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go. We're only dreaming.
Dust of the ground. And he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Genesis 2:7. And interestingly enough, God made him instantaneously intelligent. He made him name all of the creatures of the earth. Now that's amazing to me, because we can name creatures based upon a template that's already established. But Adam named them according to a pre-template. He was able to know a bird was a bird. He was able to call everything, and he saw that all of the natural order had male and female counterpart. All animals, all creatures that were living had that counterpart. But he also saw that there was not one for him. And so God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. Genesis 2:21. And he took one of his ribs, and he fashioned the woman. He did not make the woman out of the dirt like he did the man. He fashioned her. The Hebrew uses a different term. It says he literally built the woman from the man. And when Adam woke up, he didn't have to dream of what he needed. What God gave him was his dream. He said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and they shall be one flesh. What God therefore has joined together, let no man put asunder." Now the institution of marriage is under attack today. So many people don't remain married, and some people don't marry at all. But it's God's will that you do. You have to face God, and marriage is the only institution on earth where two people become one flesh. That doesn't exist anywhere else. Where that physical relationship reflects the agape love of God. Only in a marital relationship is that true. And so here we are. Here is witnesses and encouragers and also blessers of the situation. Amen.
Amen.
All right, I've known Adam for a long time. We go way back. Amen. But I appreciate his transparency. I appreciate his character. I appreciate his talent, which is very evident. His talents, plural. But I appreciate his character. I appreciate his temperament. I appreciate all of those things. I can go on and on, but I'm not going to go on and on. I've known Kimila less time. But I know she's a child of God. I know she has a Christian spirit. I can tell. A very strong, genuine Christian spirit that's reflected in a mother and grandmother as well. And so we're coming together to join them in marriage. All right? Is there a ring? All right. Very good. I kind of tell the story. When I was getting married, the ring bearer didn't want to give up the ring. So he wrestled with my brother, and they fought it out. They finally got it. Amen. All right. And Adam, if you can place that ring on her finger. Now, the ring is not the love that they share, but it's always a physical symbol to represent it. It's always a reminder of the love and the commitment that they make. You see, we have to commit ourselves in a way that it's everlasting. And that ring represents the binding of themselves together as one flesh, united before God. Amen? So Adam, repeat after me. I, Adam. Do take Kimila.
Do take Kimila.
As my lawful wedded wife.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
In riches or in poverty.
In riches or in poverty.
In health or in sickness.
In health or in sickness.
In any circumstances that can possibly come our way.
In any circumstances that can possibly come our way.
Amen. Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Amen. And if there are ring also, Kimila. All right. Now you place that on Adam's turn. Can you repeat after me? Come on. I, Kimila.
I, Kimila.
Do take you, Adam.
To be
my lawful wedded husband.
My lawful
to have and to hold. To love the church. In sickness or in health.
In
riches or in poverty.
In riches or in poverty.
Or in any circumstances that could ever come our way.
Or in any circumstances that could come our way.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Amen. Amen. Now we get to the good part. Amen. All right, according to the power that invested in me by the state of Oklahoma, but much more importantly by Jesus Christ himself. You know, the state simply is here as a recognition of God and not to replace it. And certainly in that, I do declare that Adam, Spencer, and Kimila are now husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride.
always reflect you me. When he smiled at me and he turned to me and he said to me, I'm always known.